echo in my mind. 30 years since Kailami opened up the sea sun. It's been so long since I've had high, acknowledging the progress where the rivers can show salvation. I stopped an old man along the way, asking about one legendary battle for the victory. He turned to me as if to say, FIA is waiting there for you.
Hello everyone and welcome over to South Africa for race number 15, I think. Is it 15? Yeah, 15 of season 5 of the NR 2003 PMU Cup Series. And yes, for the second time ever, we make our voyage to South Africa. And this is going to be an exciting challenge and hopefully much better compared to last race. Last race, we had a few surprises, bits and bobs, and let's say we have some good entertainment there, especially the likes of Owen Scott, Cameron Jr., everybody. Stronger, probably the strongest we've ever had in his career, following his deal with Lynn Motorsports. This is definitely the real deal for James Jamerson. Then we've Adam Wilson, hopefully up for a good day. There is Raina Naomi. We've not seen much of her in a while. Let's hope how she can improve on there. Cesar Cohen Jr. having decent performance as a rookie, even though he has not he's not running a part-time schedule yet. Cesar Cohen Jr. He's only running part-time, but not full-time in D1 at least, so he's definitely in need of a drive, if that's possible, for D1 full time towards the end of the season, or probably next season, I'm not sure. So anyway, there's Nikki Rive in his in her new livery, and I can't properly see other cars out there. So I mean deliveries and stuff. So it looks like we're gonna go in a minute. The pace track pulls in, and we're gonna get ready to go here in Africa. Here we go. Boogity boogity boogity, let's go racing in Africa. As Cam Ray, looks as though Donald Hamilton is switching from one side to another, already looking racer down there, as Cam Ray goes up in front of Drew Walker, and he retains that lead from the start. Donald Hamilton appeared to be making a lean up to second place alongside Drew Walker, and he goes up into second place, and it looks as though Drew Walker is going to lose a little bit further. James Jamerson seems to be trying to follow Donald Hamilton, trying to do exactly the same thing, but no, he does not, as Drew Walker gets up in front of James Jamerson. So Drew Walker only loses one spot so far. Cam Ray Sr. up into the lead, Donald Hamilton up into second place, and Drew Walker third place, Jamerson fourth, Wilson fifth, Iron Army sixth. Oh my gosh, Kyle Waters, he's up on the charge. I think it looks as though that he was about to kill somebody, I guess. And let's check the back to make sure everyone gets home safely. So full for everyone's good. So Cat Wright starting in the back, she's still at the back. So Cam Wright Senior continues to lead alongside Nola Hamilton and Drew Walker, and looks as though we have a battle for the lead. I mean, we have a battle for eighth place, I think. Oh well, for ninth place, I think there's a Cameron Jr. making it alongside, and here comes Kendrick Meeks as well, trying to do the exact same thing as what Cameron Jr. has done. He goes right in front of Roberto Crane Jr. Roberto Crane Jr. is about to lose spots to both of these cars. Owen Scott right behind him as well. So Roberto Crane Jr. is not in a good position right now. He's going to lose another spot to Owen Scott. And now he's got Nicky Rive right behind him. Oh my God! Let's hope we don't see a wreck. We don't see anything serious from down there. That will not look good. So everyone should be satisfied of their cars right now. Everything should be good. So let's hope these cars don't get wrecked in a short while's time. So, Drew Walker up into second place. He's gone past Nolan Hamilton. He's back up in second place. Now, it looks as though he might be able to go one up further against Cam Wright Sr. So, this is going to be really interesting to see. Nolan Hamilton still staying there. In fact, he has a really good season so far. This is certainly the best we've ever seen so far, ever in his career. He's in an unusual contention for the championship, and God knows where will he end up soon after. Oh, and Cameron Senior gets past Seth Coulthard Jr. Well, that's a rookie thing for him to do. He gives way to Cameron Jr., who's getting a lot faster now, and Kendrick Meeks seems to be on the verge of trying to try do the exact same thing. He appears to be on good tires right now, but he must save as much as he can, otherwise he will lose it. And there you go, those are your top teners are up to Kendrick Meeks. Let's see if we've got any more battles. We've got Joey Maddox trying to get in front of Dylan Hayden. Not yet. We got two Mercedes battling it out. R.I.T. Alejo and Blake Parker going side by side. This is an amazing battle in Africa. This is really easy to see cars overtaking right now. We see Leon Hill back in his Lion King livery for this race at least. Especially being in Africa. It's quite different. Oh my God, David Dixon almost got pinned by the number 44. I can't remember what that car is. I think that is Albrecht Strauss, it appears that he was so close to causing a catastrophe or
A devastation for the number 45. Let's we have another battle as well for the for a position. There's Solomon Sheridan. All right. Oh my gosh, and David Dixon appears in the picture as well, and so does Albrecht Strass. So we'll see intensifying battles for the we have lots of battles right now. Some even intensifying. So let's see. Albrecht Strass, he appeared to have touched David Dixon. He was right there. Let's see. You can see how close he was. In fact, this could have ended up in chaos. Look at that. He just pinned him. If he held on to it more, then that would have been the end for the number 45. In fact, last time David Dixon was in South Africa was pretty much bad luck. He basically got wrecked. And basically, that was almost the end of his day, I think. So, let's get back up front and see how the fronts are doing. Cam Wright Sr. still leading, but Drew Walker right behind him. Adam Wilson up into third place. He's gone past Nolo Hamilton, and James Jameson is going to try and do the same on Nolo Hamilton. We have main team versus the satellite team of Leyland Motorsports. As James Jameson gets up front, his car is really working so far. And right in an army. Seems to be running well as well. And who's... Oh, Carl Vardis. I think he's getting passed by the SLR car of Ray in an army. And it looks like he might try and do the same. But it looks like he's still clinging on the back of her. Cameron Jr. right behind Carl Vardis. Looks like he might be making a move as well. And here comes Giuliano, trying to get around Dylan Hayden. Oh my gosh, I see smoke. I see smoke. What happened? We'll find out what happened. Let's see what happened. So, oh my god. Who, what happened? Who's that? I think that's Vartors. He got sent onto the grass. What happened? Is that Camry Jr.? Oh my gosh. He did. Carl Vartors onto the grass. And that was a close shave. I don't think that was not a good idea for Camry Jr. to do. We got to take a look at that replay. That's a similar replay. That reminds me of last race when, Owen Scott basically clipped to the back of Cam Wright Sr. and put him onto the wall and basically lost a lot of time as a result of that. And that, as a result, meant that Owen Scott basically lost the race win to Cam Wright Jr. So, yeah, so Owen Scott got disqualified. He got penalized as a result of that collision he caused to Cameron Sr. But let's take a look at that replay of that similar near miss. Well, what could have happened, the same thing as last season here at this race, as Carl Vardis got sent onto the grass from by Cameron Jr. as he gets overtaken. That is pretty much a dirty thing for him to do. Yeah, that is pretty dirty. Pretty dirty to see. So let's go on board Carl Vartors the moment he gets sent onto the grass. And he could have lost control of his car and could have probably smashed into the other cars, getting into their way. So anyway, so let's get back. To live as we see now. Cesar Cohen Jr. is trying. I think, maybe Carl Vardis might be trying to get his position back from Cesar Cohen Jr. And that, as a result, will give Kendrick Meeks the opportunity of a pass. Of Sasa Cohen Jr. And it looks promising for the number 10, and he goes up front. Carvalho doesn't look really happy right now for Camry Jr. Last race winner at this track. He inherited the win from Owen Scott after that disqualification from the race. Back up front now, his father Camry Sr. still up front. Drew Walker still right behind him in second place. And Adam Wilson might be an interesting one as well to see. Look around and can see there's Lyndon Hill, and he's got Danu Bouchard catching him. This is a very easy track to see when it comes to overtakes. As Camry Jr., we don't know what's going to happen to him after the race, and he approaches one of his teammates as Ray and an army up at front. We're still green so far. I missed a few near misses going along. Although that could hopefully change. We are in lap 7 still, so... And I hope to God this stream is working okay. Just a double check if anyone's watching. This stream should bring as much quality as we can possibly can. Oh my God, look at that. Look at that. Lots of overtaking opportunities to see. Oh, someone's smoking. Who's smoking? It's Petty Jr. I mean, Sophia Petty is out of the race with a blown engine. And he's trying to get away. This is not the first time we've seen her blow up. And he's definitely getting to other drivers' way. What is she thinking now? What is she thinking? Oh my God, Lyndon Hill looks at, look at that, he is blocking almost intentionally. I have no idea what was going on with her right now. What is she continuing on the track, blowing up? She could have just stopped by, and she's blocking Lola Chernside. What is going on with Sophia Petty? I have no idea. But that could have been a similar... This could have been a similar situation back at Bristol, where she basically blown an engine and ended up parking onto the track and wasn't able to make her way out of the track, and as a result she got hit by the other drivers behind her. So that was very awful to see. And this situation, her blowing up, this is very different. She literally wouldn't give way to other drivers. She wouldn't even move aside. That is honestly pretty awful to see. That is certainly something that needs to be investigated after the race. What was going on with this number 43 car? People are pissed off with her right now. And that will affect on the times. Camry Sr. still leading. And Drew Walker still no way of starting a battle against the ATA. Probably that could change in the next few laps when the tire starts to give up a little bit. And here comes Camry Jr. on right in an army. And he makes a move. He goes alongside the number 18. And will he make it? And he does make it. He gets past Rain and Army for fifth place. Fifth place, I think. Mix in 8th place, 9th place Carl Bartos, and Seth Cohen Jr. stays in 10th position. Andrew Walker's getting a bit closer to Cameron Senior. Looks like a battle would happen in the next few moments. Cameron Senior's tires are starting to give up. I mean, this could be a matter of time before potentially the first pit window will open. Cameron Senior trying to hold his lead now. Looks like he's going to try and defend his position for the next few laps, as he's got a more fresher, tired Drew Walker right behind him. So now things about to get more interesting now. Looks like Adam Wilson might be trying to do the same. I think he's catching up to them as well. Looks as though he's free now. We're seeing in sight now. But we're seeing more of a war between Dodge and the Chevy. And we have an interesting battle at the rear as Lola Churnside trying to make up for lost time from that unfortunate situation with Sophia Petty, which unfortunately led to also a huge row for Hilmi's. Oh, what's happened to Lola Churnside? She's slowing down. This is getting unfortunate. I thought she's getting position. She is getting slower and slower. What is going on with Lola Churnside? She's slowing down. Oh my gosh, she's slowing down. What on earth is going on right now? Cars are slowing down and grinding to a halt. Now that is unfortunate. That is unexpected to see. Well, we'll find out later on what happened to the number 5 very shortly, or whenever we get the information from Leland Motorsports. Anyway, back up to the front. Cameron Senior is still in the lead right now. And Drew Walker and potentially, I think, Adam Wilson might be coming close and probably trying to take part in this potential battle for the lead. We've seen no change of position in the top three, at least as of yet. But things could happen very shortly. Things could change very shortly. And Nola Hamilton getting close to James Jamerson. He's trying to move up again. In fact, he's got other cars right behind. Looks as though Nola Hamilton might have benefits of drafting right behind him. So this could mean a potential overtake on James Jamerson if it goes on to plan. if it goes well to plan. And Nolan Hamilton gets around the number 19. He gets closer and closer and closer. What will he do next? And Kendrick Meeks trying to get around the 18. Still no change up front. And there is Thomas Giuliano. In fact, he's been behind the 90, I believe, for quite a long while now. It looks as though this is not getting any better for Dylan Hayden, already right behind the number 3. Now we have a scramble and a battle for fourth place, I think. Nola Hamilton is trying to get around the number 19, still to no avail. And as well as Kendrick managed to, well, he's still on a battle against the number 18 for a position up. That is for seventh position. Oh, and Nola Hamilton loses the ground. He's now gone really wide as he tries to get past 98, but it seems that is not going to work for him. Now he loses positions as well to Cam Ray Jr. He gets right in front of the 55. And number 55 still under intense pressure from the cars behind him. There is Ryan Anami trying to do the same thing as well, was trying to keep this battle running between her and the number 10. Carl Voldus also joins the party as well. Brandon Army, thanks to Carl Voldus' drive, I think that gives number 18 a pass to try and retake her position she lost. Probably that's not going to help, I think. Or is this going to help? Is the battle's not done yet? Oh, and here comes Brandon Army. Looks like she's back up front of the Mercedes car. Probably all thanks to the number 62. And we're looking at another battle, I think. That is Owen Scott appearing to try to make a move on the number 22. Still no change at the front. Now Camaro Jr. has now got James Jamerson to deal with now before he continues to move up a position. Oh, looks like it's going to be a pit stop coming in. Oh, someone's went off the grass. I think that's just normal because it happens. Yeah, it happens. That's normal. So, yeah, pit stops are coming in at lap 17. So, we now got 11 laps to go. So, where is everybody? And the senior gets up front of Drew Walker again, and so does Adam Wilson, so still no change coming up. Oh, and Cameron Jr. seems to be on a more racing right now. Is this is this almost illegal to see Cameron trying to overtake the number 19 just before they leave the pit line? It looks as though that's Cameron Jr. keeps his position until the line disappears, so that's legal, so that's fine. If he had cut that line, that would not be legal. That would have been potential penalty, I think, for Cameron Jr. just for cutting the line of the number for the number 19 here before that ends. So anyway, so number 18 still leads, but 47 still close from the number number 47 is still close. And look at him, number 47 looks as though he's going to try and make a move now. This is the first time we're seeing Drew Walker this close, and he's getting closer and closer to the Dodge. Still no yellow flag as of yet. And Leighton Hill versus David Dixon, they're also getting really close. And we have another Leighton Motorsports car, technically a Leighton Motorsports car, that is Avery Hamilton, I think, right in front of him. Well, they're going to need to pit really soon. I don't think they've pitted yet. Unless they have, well, that would be my mistake. But we'll find out eventually, hopefully, if we get to see them. They haven't pitted yet. Or in fact, we'll find out from now if they have pitted. They have not pitted yet, so... Anyway, who is supposed to lead? Well, Meeks is leading, but obviously he'll have to pit. But there we've got Kyle Vaughters trying to make a move. We do hope to see the round of pit stops ending pretty soon after the last cars make their pit stops. And David Dixon gets front in both, not just Leighton Hill, but CJ Williams as well. CJ Williams also gets past Leighton Hill. Upper position. That's getting intensified right now. So we might see a close fuel mileage race coming up to the end of the race, because some of the cars are still opting to stay for longer before their first pit stops. I think they're trying to make up for lost time to save up as much, or at least use as much tires as they can, as well as use as much fuel as they can. That could be fuel mileage, I suppose. And Meeks makes a pit stop, I think. Yeah, he does make a pit stop, but Carl Walters stay out. Who else is going to make the pit stops? Gonzalez makes a pit stop. And Simmons makes a pit stop. These drivers will not make a pit stop just yet. These drivers need to make a pit stop really soon. So now technically Cam Wright Sr. is still leading. Anyway, so Carl Walters is technically still leading. And Carl Walters will finally make a pit stop. Who else will make a pit stop? Joe Maddox stays out. Giuliano stays out. Avery Hamilton comes in. Looks as though Cameron Senior is getting heated up right now. He's got one of the supposed lap cars right behind him. That is John Palmer. So now these two are going to have to make a move now. They're going to have to get put up with these cars now. And thanks to John Palmer, Cameron Senior has got a bit of room, but not completely though, because he's got other cars right in front of him who have still yet to make a pit stop so far. And he gets past Austin Leung. Thank you, boy. I can take the space now. Oh, and Adam Wilson now giving Drew Walker the pressure. We'll have to wait and see later on. So what's going on, everybody? They're still staying out for God knows how long. Anyway, Maddox continues to lead with Thomas Giuliano and Daniel Bouchard. And Joe Maddox stays out for God knows how long. They stay out as well. What is going on with these cars up front? When are they going to make a pit stop? Otherwise, I'm going to push them at the back. Because that's not supposed to happen. Unless we can get a caution, that could bring up to their attention.
Well, Cameron Senior is trying to move up as much as he can possibly can. Now he's in eighth place so far, supposedly leading. Come on, what the fuck are you doing? I don't know what's going on. I've not heard much about them. That's their problem to deal with. Some of them are still staying out. So these gonna have to go to the back as well. They're not pitting, and this is already lap three. We've got three laps to go. This is a rule that every car, unless stated otherwise, maybe if on races where on tracks where there's no pit stop for any reason, these cars need to make a mandatory pit stop. If they don't come in before the end of the race, these cars will be sent to the back immediately, as in right to the back. So literally that way. So behind the last car that I've pitted, they'll be sent to the back in order of how they finished. That is the rule. So this, we need to keep, someone's blown up. Owen Scott blows up. That, his day has come to an end, sadly. Owen Scott is out. Let's hope he makes it in one piece. Oh my gosh, that was a close shave. That could have ended up in chaos. And he's blocking. They're still staying out, and they are seriously violating protocol. I'm not happy right now. This ought to stop. Cameron Senior is in fourth place, so he is trying to make up for lost time. He has no idea what was going on. Why these cars have not pitted? Why is this game playing up? That's the big question mark. This should not have happened. Literally, this should not have happened. Now he's got Alejo. Well, no, Bouchard, I think, right in front of him now. We go on the helicopter footage now this time. perhaps maybe a full mile to the end, that would be it. That could be something. If they if they actually pit towards the end of the race, that would be insane. But it looks as though they haven't, so that's definitely going to be a penalty for a number of cars that have not pitted. So Joe Maddox didn't pit. Giuliano didn't pit. There's Cameron Senior. There's Drew Walker. Adam Wilson. CJ Williams did not come to his pit. Lynn Hill did not come to his pit. Riley Hill as well did not come to his pit. So does Kat Rose. And there's Cameron Jr. There's Ryan Anami. Jim Jimison. Austin Leon also didn't come to his pit stop. Mix didn't come to his pit stop. Didn't he come? No, he did. Mix did. My bad. Not sure about Sheridan. I'm not sure. I'll take a look at Sheridan, but I'm certain. Yeah, I think, yeah. There's Nolan Hamilton. There's Vartre. He did make his pit stop as well. So most of the cars up to Aston Leon, they will get a penalty to the back for not pitting in. Oh, they have pitted. They are pitting. Are they pitting towards the end? Who's that? Miyazaki's pitting right to the end of the race. Or were they on a fuel mileage or something? I don't know. So, alright, so Joe Maddox is not gonna win. He's gonna get sent to the back. So Cameron Senior will take the win. Then Thomas Giuliano will be sent to the back. Drew Walker comes second place. Adam Wilson's third place. CJ Williams, Lynn Hill will get sent to the back. Junior will get sent to the back. And Ryan Anami will finish required. So James Jameson also will finish. I think Riley Hill will get sent to the back. I'll double check on Riley Hill. Meeks, I've definitely saw. Sheridan, I'll double check. Kat Rose definitely hasn't pitted. And Aston Leong. And probably check a few others as well. So there you go. So I don't know, maybe I will need to fix something in the track in our files, because that shouldn't have happened. Literally, it's not normal. So why the hell would they have an advantage by just simply not pitting? That's just unrealistic. So they can't simply do that. So this game shouldn't have happened like that. I thought this is gonna happen this way, but it didn't, so that's not how it is. So results need to be worked out. So that is going to be something. Yeah, we need to look at this. Will be a formal investigation. We'll throw out the final results after this race. But so far, Cameron Senior will win provisionally here at South Africa. If anyone wants to come and sort out with me, feel free. I can take as long as I can, probably an hour before the next race. So I think I'm gonna don't know if I can do it live, or I can do it off live. I could probably do it live just to check it. It might not take a long time, I guess. So yeah. So anyway, so let's go down in order. So I don't know who's the last driver that I've not pitted to finish. I will double check on Nicky Rive, I think. Although I'm not sure if I can check all the drivers, because I can sometimes forget. Or actually, come to think of it, this is something that will save, that will tell the truth. So let me check the local host web. This will determine which drivers have pitted, which drivers have not pitted. So there you go. So here you go. So as I'm looking right now, Joe Maddox has not pitted. Thomas Giuliano did not pit. CJ Williams didn't pit. Leighton Hill did not pit. And AJ Duny did not pit. Riley Hill didn't pit. And Kat Rose did not pit. And Solomon Schur didn't pit. Austin Leong didn't pit. And Nolan Hamilton didn't pit as well. Wait, Nolan Hamilton? I thought Nolan Hamilton did pit. That's the big question mark. Oh no, sorry. I read the lead numbers. Sorry, my bad. Let's try again. So, Joe Maddox didn't pit. Thomas Giuliano did not pit. CJ Williams didn't pit. Lynn Hill did not pit. AJ Duny did not pit. Riley Hill did not pit. Rose did not pit. Austin Leong did not pit. So, sorry, Solomon Sheridan, you did pit Sheridan. And I guess that's it. So, these will need to follow the rules because they simply violated that rule. So, this cannot have happened. So, at the moment, these drivers will be moved back. So, I'm going to sort out the results to see how this could affect the results. So, let me get a thought out right now. So anyone behind those drivers will obviously gain a spot, so more points for those who are at the back. Oh, and David Dixon did pit, as confirmed, so I didn't mention him, so David Dixon did pit. So I shall confirm that. So the rest, everyone else that I've mentioned, so they've not pitted. So yeah, I don't know if I can sort it out now or probably sort it out after the stream. I don't know what to do. So so that means Sophia Petty and Owen Scott will be 38 and 39 respectively because of retirements, I think. Oh no, because Owen Scott's retired after two laps? And then Chernsai finished three laps back. So maybe, yeah, I think Chernsai will keep her 38th place, so Owen Scott 37th. So basically, that means that Liang will be pushed down to 36th place, and 35th would be Kat Rose, then 34th would be Riley Hill, 33rd would be Judney, and I think 33rd would be Leighton Hill, then 32nd would be CJ Williams. And 31st will be Thomas Giuliano. And 30th would be Joy Maddox. So those drivers will be lined up to the back. The rest will gain positions. So that means that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 drivers will move down. So I will need to sort out the results after this race because I can't tell from my head of who would finish where. So, but maybe things can change. I don't know. This is just my decision of what needs to be done because I'm seeing people already on the Discord already having a go at me on Discord right now. That's just unbelievable. Okay, someone's complaining because he hasn't pitted. Doesn't mean that he would lose a spot. So what? That's just the game. If you haven't pitted, you haven't pitted. That's not supposed to be part of the game. I didn't see it, so I didn't expect this to happen, so I'm not sure if it's worth maybe fixing the track in II thing to see, just to make sure everyone is leveled up correctly. I mean, I could test the track for next race, otherwise I'm not sure whether this track will be in the schedule next season because of how stupid the track was behaving. Well, maybe not the track, but how the cars were behaving on the track. So that's something I was not expected to get put up with now. This is why I hate my job, because when things happen, I get mad. So that's something I need to, I keep repeating this point over and over again. Well, anyway, let me get to the track NI ASAP. So that means we'll work it out. So let's see if things can work out from there. Maybe go a bit early, I think. So that means make the tires more wear out, I think. Okay, so Kyalami. So what if I don't know if I can maybe push it to maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe 1.39 for both tire wear. We'll test it out after the race, just to see if we can make a difference. Hopefully, if there's no yellow flags, because when there's a yellow flag, that's a different story. But for races that don't end under or under caution, or don't end with a caution, or there's no caution on the race, then this should how it should play up. So what I'm seeing right now, it's pretty an unusual situation. So anyway, so I guess we'll end it right now. I'm going to send the proof of the drivers I've not made a pit stop onto the Discord chat, because I've got proof. I can just send it right now. I'll do so. So this can make it easier for me to sort out the results and stuff like that, so we can also work it out. So anyway, let's wrap it up. We'll have a bit of a rest, give it about an hour or so, or maybe two, and then we can hopefully get Germany started then. So apologies for this unfortunate situation we've had. So there we go. And you know what? Let's take a look at the fastest lap time before we go. So Drew Walker will take home the fastest lap time for 1:21.734. So there you go. So Camaro Senior will win. Well, at the moment here at South Africa, I will put the results down at the bottom of the screen if I do need to. If you haven't seen it, then do assume that the results will stand as it is. But as I keep saying, results will be down, the final results, in the description, yeah, in case so that would make it fair for everyone, and for those who don't know or get confused by it. So anyway, so let's rack it up for a bit, and yep, let's move on to Germany, hopefully soon, if we can sort out the problem. So thank you everyone for watching this stream, and I shall hopefully see you at Germany next. Take care everyone, and I'll see you there.